girls, it's Jamie. I see that a lot of you have left comments wondering what my place looks like. I know that you think since I'm a DIY girl, my walls must be covered in art. Au contraire.
My walls are actually pretty blank.
But you gals have inspired me to cover my walls with artistic awesomeness, which is why this week I'm going to show you how to make multi-canvas wall art. Let's do it, girl. For your multi-canvas wall art, you're going to need a lot of wall space. And then you're going to need a map or a large poster, scissors and a pencil, Mod Podge or watered down glue, acrylic paint and paintbrush, a tape measure or ruler, needle nose pliers, a hammer and small nails, small gauge wire, small easy grip hooks, newspaper to keep things clean, and blank canvases. Now your canvases are going to be the base for your poster, so make sure to carefully measure your poster's height and width using your tape measure or ruler. Now what this means is that your collection of canvases must fit these constraints. So to avoid any confusion, write down the measurements ahead of time and even bring a calculator with you to the craft store. Step one, go ahead and search your closet or run out to a thrift store and pick up a really large poster. I'm using a poster of a map because I love to travel.
Since my poster is 27 inches by 20 inches, I bought a bunch of canvases that were 8x8, 8x10, and 4x4 in order to fit those constraints.
Do you see how when I put all the canvases together that they fit the map perfectly?
Step 3. Using your pencil, lightly mark the front of the poster where each canvas ends. Using your scissors, cut out your poster into your canvas-shaped pieces. You can use a paper cutter or X-Acto knife here too if you have it. Step 4. Paint the outline of your canvas to match your poster. Since my poster is mostly baby blue, I'm going to paint the sides the same way by mixing a combination of paints. Let the paint dry for at least 15 minutes.
Step 5. Now's the time to grab your Mod Podge and get gluing.
Add a light coat on one canvas, and then press your corresponding poster piece firmly down on top, making sure it's completely flattened and avoiding any glue bubbles. Repeat for every canvas.
A trick is to turn your canvas upside down and then add on a book or something to add drying weight.
When finished, let the glue dry for about 15 minutes. Step 6.
Once it's dry, go ahead and cover the tops, bottoms, and sides of your canvases in a final coat of Mod Podge. This will ensure that your poster stays glued to that canvas.
Step 7. Using your hammer and nail, hang up your wall art. Using your needle nose pliers, wrap your small gauge wire around one nail and leave a little bit of slack before attaching it to your second nail. This will give you a way to hang your canvases. The last step is to hang up your wall art using your hammer and nail or easy grip hooks. Leave a couple of inches between each canvas, but make sure that the top, bottom, and sides of your canvases line up evenly. And you're all done.
What other ways can you make multi-canvas wall art your own personal style? Tweet me at Jamie Petito or tell me all about it in the comments below.
We now have a fun and cost-saving way to make your boring white walls scream for joy with your artistic ability.
And by that I mean I now have a fun way of making my boring white walls awesome. Thanks for the inspiration, girls.
We did it, girl.
I'm Jamie and you're on girl.com. All the girls across the world should subscribe to our channel.
Hammer time. Boom, boom, boom.
The next step. Those were three notes, but not necessarily three notes from Hammer Time.
They were not three notes from Hammer Time.
Your hands are really soapy.
Oh, they are really soapy. I was washing my paintbrush.
Yeah, right?